Hello, everybody, and welcome to Check It Out, a monthly show about what's happening at the Bethel Park Public Library. I'm Mary Mullen.
I'm Elaine Volpe.
And Elaine and I are here today to let everybody know about what's coming up in the library in September, because this is our
fall, end of the summer, already here.
Already here, fall preview time, right?
Yes.
So I think we're going to let you get started. But tell us what's going to be happening in the children's department.
Sure thing. So all of our story times in preschool programming will start back up the week of September 10th. So as you know, we have Book Babies for the very little, birth to 18 months. That is year-round, and it's Thursdays at 10 a.m. And that's a happy story time. It's about 25 minutes long with stories and songs and finger plays mostly, and then we do a shared reading at the end. Mother Goose is the next step up. That's for 18 months to 2.5-year-olds. That story time takes place on Wednesdays at 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock, and that's pretty much an extension of Book Babies. Still a lot of singing and rhyming going on, and then she'll do a story or two as well. Then we have Toddler Story Time for your 2.5 to 3.5-year-old, and that takes place on Tuesdays at 10 or 11. And then finally, on Fridays is our preschool story time at 10, 11, or 1. There's also an afternoon session for that one. Ms. Sharon focuses on a different letter of the alphabet each week to help prepare your child for kindergarten. All of those story times do not require registration, but if you have any questions, feel free to give us a call upstairs. Ms. Dawn will also be doing her Kinder Ready program on Tuesdays at 1 p.m. This is if you have a child entering kindergarten in the fall of 2013. It's a kindergarten readiness program where she'll work on many skills that they need for the start of school, including, you know, your cooperation and communication skills, but also your phonics and your print awareness, language, and all of that. So that's a great program, but registration is limited. So for that one, you do need to call ahead, and registration will begin on September 1st. We're doing Little Hands Art once a month, Thursday evenings. So if you have a young budding artist, like 2 to 6-year-olds, like really young, and they like to, paint or color and have fun, then Little Hands Art each month will have a different project for your toddler to do. What else is new? Mother Goose on the Loose, for parents who work during the week, I always like to offer something either in the evenings or on the weekends. So Saturday mornings in September, we'll be doing a story time that's most appropriate for babies up to 3 years old. It's called Mother Goose on the Loose. And then our Step Together workshop isn't happening for a while, but I will mention it. That's part of the Family Place grant that we got. At least once a year, we like to hold this workshop. It's a 5-week-long workshop. It'll begin in November and run on into December. But we highlight a different important topic each week, relevant for your baby. Again, we focus on 0 to 3 years old, but we talk about speech and language development, child development, how music should play a role in your baby's life, all kinds of good stuff. So again, we'll remind you as the time gets closer. That's not until November, but we are doing that this fall as well. Family programs, we have our grandparent story time, which is always a special time. Grandparents' Day is on Sunday, September 9th, so we're holding a special program at 2 o'clock. You can celebrate Grandparents' Day with us with stories, bingo, and a special keepsake craft. So a lot of good stuff going on for the wee little ones, although grandparent story time is for all ages. But then we have programs just for grade schoolers, talking K-4, K-5. And this fall, we decided to try something different, a little bit different. We're just running a bunch of clubs, and we're even starting a Scrabble club. I know the adults have been doing a Scrabble club for quite some time now, so we're going to give that a try. We're doing a chess club. Lego club has been very popular this summer, so we're going to continue that this fall. Reader's Theater Club, I've had a ton of fun with my Reader's Theater group, so we're going to continue on in the fall. A Reader's Advisory, we're going to do a boys-only book club Fridays in October, and a science club. And then, of course, our mother-daughter book club is still going strong, as well as American Girl Book Club. But all of these book clubs will also start in September. The flyer looks like this. It's now available upstairs, also available online. So check out the programs. Give us a call if you want to register or if you need any more information. I'm going to highlight a couple of the teens before I pass it on over to you. We have Mr. Hartman, who has been retired for quite some time, but a longtime volunteer in the Catholic schools. He was at St. Bow's for a while, and he's now over at St. Catherine Drexel, and he helps out over there. He's actually going to come to the library and do a few classes for our tweens and teens. fifth grade and up. But he's going to talk about great inventors that you don't know, right?
That's
ones that, and there's so many out there. Or those that you might think, you know, everybody credits Thomas Edison with the invention of the light bulb. Not so. Not true.
Really?
So we're going to discover who really did invent the light bulb and among lots and lots of other things. Really cool, neat inventions, everyday gadgets that you probably use every day and take for granted. Did you ever, did you ever stop to think, hey, where'd that come from? Or who came up with this idea? Mm-hmm. So he's going to highlight unknown inventors. So that'll be a great class. That's Sunday, September 16th at 4 p.m. He's also going to talk about the Great Depression. You know, he lived through the Great Depression, so he kind of has an inside perspective, firsthand look at it. So he's going to talk about what life was really like during the Great Depression and how it affected families and how it affected, you know.
And we're getting further and further away from that time.
That's true. You know, I know they still learn about it in the schools, but I don't think they really delve into it in depth as much anymore. Mm-hmm. And it's such a, you know, important topic.
And it's always helpful, I think, when you can get it firsthand.
Right, because I think you relate to it better. Mm-hmm. And it's much more interesting than reading it out of a textbook.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So that's also a Sunday class. It'll be Sunday, September 23rd at 4 p.m. The Tween and Teen Mother-Daughter Book Club will be starting back up. And Zombie Invasion, we're going to do in October. We'll talk about it again during the September show.
Mm-hmm.
But you can mark your calendars for a Zombie Invasion on Saturday, October 20th at 7 p.m. So a lot of good stuff. We're really excited about it, as always. And again, check out our website or give us a call.
Yeah. Sounds like a lot of great programs coming.
Yeah,
you guys
we're
are going to be busy.
I want to
thank again.
Yes. So this is kind of our downtime, right? Mm. Summer reading's over, but we're getting ready to start up in September. Having mentioned summer reading, I just want to thank everybody for another successful year. We had a lot of fun. The program for school age kids, K through 5, was different this year, so we kind of were testing out the waters, so to speak. So I thank everybody for their patience, and I hope you had as much fun as we did. But it was another successful summer that flew by and went way too fast. I feel like every year, I say it every year, but I feel like every year it goes quicker and quicker.
It does get quicker.
Do you feel that way?
Absolutely. No.
And as
no
I don't know, I have two, you know, I have two young boys. I think as the kids get older, it goes quicker and quicker.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if it's because they're involved in more and you're constantly on the go or what it is, but they sure do fly by.
They do.
All right, so tell us what's going on the adult side.
Well, this is kind of our downtime, has been a downtime for adult programs also, but we are getting ready for a full lineup of programs in the fall, and I'm going to give everybody an idea of what's coming up in September. The library, we're actually going to start off the fall season with our fall Wise Walk program. And we've been doing this again. This is one of our regular programs. We've been doing it for years. And this is a 10-week walking program for older adults, 50-plus. We're going to kick off on Thursday, August 30th at 9:30 here at the library. We always start here at the library. I have a guest speaker coming in. Her name is Joanna Scholder, and Joanna is an expert on exercise and fitness and walking for older adults. So that'll be 9:30, August 30th, and then we will be walking in South Park.
Okay, I was going to say, and then if inclement weather, then you head to the track at the community center, right?
Then we go over to the community center track. So to register, just give us a call here at the library. And of course, September means school starting, right?
School back to school. I already bought my supplies.
You already
have to do the, you know, back to school outfits. Go shopping for that this weekend.
Are your boys
new shoes and all that?
Are your boys looking forward to going back to school?
Yes and no. I think they want to, you know, hang with their friends, see everybody that they haven't seen this summer. But of course, they're not looking forward to the schoolwork. I've been giving them to prep them. I've given them some assignments each day. You know, some work out of the math book. Have to read so many chapters. So I'm not their favorite person right now. But, you know, I'm helping them. In the long run, I'm definitely helping them. It's that summer slide. You want to get them back into the swing of things.
Mm-hmm.
Bedtime, too. Like, they've been letting them stay up later.
Right.
Well, last night we were in bed at 9 o'clock sharp.
Well, good for you.
Well, we tried. By the time they fell asleep, it was a little bit later. But you want to get them back into that routine.
Mm-hmm. And that's always a challenge.
It really is.
It is a challenge. Well, with school, you know, just around the corner, the library will be offering a program. It is a free SAT test practice.
Mm-hmm.
This is presented by Kaplan, and that will be Saturday, September 1st from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. And you then will get your scores along with some test-taking strategies and important information on Tuesday, September 11th at 7 p.m. So this is two parts. You take your free practice test on the 1st of September, and then you'll get your scores.
And then you come back to
get your scores on Tuesday, September 11th at 7 p.m. And I know that's always
that
an
sense.
Anxious time.
I'll tell you what, it's never too early to start prepping for the SATs either. So I think this is a great course, opportunity.
It's a great opportunity for anybody who's getting close to college. Yeah. Then on Thursday, September 6th, we also have another program that actually may be of interest to students too. This is a program for both adults and young adults, and it is Achieving Peak Performance. It's presented by Tom Cray of the Black Hawk Consulting Corporation. And he is going to be doing an introductory seminar that will help participants develop the attitudes and self-leadership skills to achieve short and long-term success. And it's going to focus on developing habits that will help you achieve work-life balance, which is always a challenge, a very difficult skill to acquire.
To master, yeah.
So this this could be a program that would be good for young adults who are looking for some academic success, and then for adults who are looking for some career success. So Achieving Peak Performance on Thursday, September 6th at 7 p.m. The Western Pennsylvania Society of Adlerian Psychology will be doing another free workshop. They've been doing a series of free workshops here at the library, and they will be here on Saturday, September 15th at 10 a.m., and their topic will be ADHD, which is Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder. And they will be talking about how to diagnose it and how to treat it, and then interventions from the Adlerian perspective. And that's a free program, but there are continuing education credits available, and there is a fee for that. So that's Saturday, September 15th at 10 a.m. And then there's a program that I think will be of interest to a lot of people, and that is a paper organizing class, and it's Conquering the Paper Pileup.
My.
What do you think, Miss Elaine?
Wow. I didn't know about this. When's this one? So I can mark my calendar.
Wednesday, September 19th at 7 p.m.
We have one counter at home that just gets, you know, it's our mail pile, but then it's schoolwork, and then it's just junk, it's a little bit of everything. Then, like, I hate when that starts to spread onto the dining room table and kind of takes over our dining room table. Then you know it's really a problem. So, wow, that'll be a great class.
I'm sure
a lot of people will take advantage of that.
It's presented by Jill Yesko from Discover Organizing, and Jill is a professional organizer, and she's going to help you eliminate those piles of paper that you build up in both your home and your office. And I'm right with you there, because I will put my mail into a basket. I should look at it that day that it comes.
Right.
I should go through it, but
you
I don't
always have time.
I don't always
you
have
know?
Time. And the weekends come, and then I'm looking at this big pile of unopened mail going, oh.
Yeah.
And I'm a paper person.
You hold on to things too.
I do. Like, I do.
So then it becomes a question, well, how long do you hold on to these bills or these texts or forms? You know?
This may be the digital age, but I can have my paper. I just feel better when I've got my paper.
I think a lot of people do.
So that's Wednesday, September 19th at 7 p.m. And then travel consultants Mirella Selfo and Cindy Sullivan will be here. They've done some travel programs for us in the past, and they're going to give us the best of Italy and Spain.
Ooh,
that does sound good. They're going to take you on a journey to explore Rome, Venice, and Florence, and then on to Spain to see Madrid and Barcelona. So that sounds like a great
program. Sounds exciting.
That does. That's Thursday, September 20th at 7 p.m. And on that same evening, September 20th, again, also at 7 p.m., we're starting a new book club. This is a crossover book club. And if you are an adult who has enjoyed reading either The Hunger Games or the Twilight series, which were books really written
for young adults,
then you might enjoy this book club, in which you're going to be talking about reading and discussing young adult books that have adult appeal. So the first meeting will be September 20th at 7 p.m. So the group will be meeting on the third Thursday of each month. The book that you'll be talking about, you should be reading, is called Under the Never Sky by Veronica Rossi. I don't know if you've heard of that.
I have not read that one, no.
I haven't heard of it either. But it sounds like it will be very appealing for people who've enjoyed The Hunger Games and Twilight series. It's kind of a science fiction set in the future kind of thing. It's
excellent. And since you mentioned Hunger Games, we do have a teen program coming up this fall. Not until November. It'll be November 2nd. But mark your calendars because it's going to be a big one. We're looking forward to it. Have you read The Hunger Games, Mary?
I have not read The Hunger Games.
I'll tell you, I kind of put it off. I didn't think I'd like it as much as I did. Once I picked it up, I couldn't put it down. I read 1, 2, and 3, bam, 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 right in a row. But you probably would surprise yourself, and I think you would like it.
I would like it.
I haven't seen it yet. That's on my list of things to do. But, yeah, I'm excited about the program. So tweens and teens and adults can, of course, stay. Friday, November 2nd, we'll be doing a big Hunger Games program.
That sounds great. Well, lots of things for people who like that kind of genre of reading. On September 25th, that's a Thursday evening at 7 o'clock, Arlene Stevens, who is a Reiki teacher and master, will be here. She's done programming for us before, mm-hmm. so you will help you discover the power of Reiki on Thursday, September 25th at 7 p.m. Then Wednesday, September 26th, we have a daytime program. It's our Lunch and Learn program is Cemetery Tales, Pittsburgh's Buried Art and History. And this is presented by the Frick Art and Historical Center. And this is an armchair. Yeah, I'm looking forward to this. This is an armchair tour of Pittsburgh's picturesque cemeteries with stories about the famous Pittsburghers buried there.
Who were buried there.
And we're also going to look at the art and design of tombstones and memorials. So that's Wednesday, September 26th at noon. And since it's a lunch and learn, that means you bring your back lunch and we'll serve a beverage and dessert. So join us on that day. And also that evening, again, September 26th at 7 p.m., we have another interesting program called Celebrating Women from the South Hills, One Story at a Time. And this is presented by a group called Wise Women South Hills of Pittsburgh. And they publish an online journal, an e-journal, and it's called Wise Women Life. And it's really designed to inspire and connect dynamic women of the Pittsburgh South Hills area. So it was it's a website put together mm-hmm. by all local women.
That's a great
and
idea.
And it gives you the opportunity to learn about, as they say, the very cool things that women in the South Hills are doing. So that's Wednesday, September 26th at 7 p.m. So we got a ton.
Yes, you have a lot lined up just for September.
Just for September. Of course, all of our regular programs will be in place. Our genealogy group will be getting back together again on Monday, September 24th, again at 7 o'clock. And one thing I want to do, we're going to introduce your interview.
Yes, I had the pleasure of going on location this month to interview a local author.
Okay, we want everyone to stay tuned for Elaine's interview. But I also want to kind of give a shout out to Harry Nordstrom. Harry was our guest in May. He's with the Greater Pittsburgh Dahlia Society. Yes. We had a wonderful interview.
We did. It was great.
And I just want to remind our viewers that the Dahlia Show that Harry mentioned will be happening at Trax Farms on Saturday, September 15th. Now, I checked on the Trax Farms calendar, mm-hmm. and they have it on their calendar for that one day, but I thought Harry said that it's actually a two-day event, Saturday and Sunday, and then Sunday is the day when the flower show is over. So you can go down and see the beautiful dahlias right. that the members have been growing all summer long. But I thought Harry said that on the second day of the show, they give away the flowers that they bring.
Wonderful.
So you might want to check with Trax to see if that's true, see if they're going to be there on Sunday and go down and
Definitely. See
the beautiful flowers and get some flowers to bring home for you. So why don't you tell us a little bit about your interview with this?
So as I said, I had the pleasure of interviewing Michael Bozzelli on his brand new book entitled Below Average Genius. Michael spent a lot of time in L.A., just recently moved back to Pittsburgh a couple years ago, and he writes a weekly column for the Washington Observer. This book is actually a compilation of all his mm-hmm. best articles or his favorite articles. Laugh out loud, funny. I started to bookmark my favorite ones, Mary, for mm-hmm. you, because I know you haven't read it yet, but there's so many favorites I really couldn't do that. I'd have post-its all over the place. So the whole book is really great. He's gotten 5-star reviews on Amazon so far.
Oh, wonderful.
And it's been a top seller. So yeah, get your copy today. The library did order two, so we will have this book available in our library. And Michael will actually be coming to Bethel Park sometime in the spring. I know he set that up with Rob. So you'll get a chance to see him in person and maybe have him sign your book if you do order it. Mm-hmm. He's doing some book signings currently around the area at some local bookstores and coffee shops. So we're excited to have him, and it was really great to go on location. I interviewed him at his home in Scott Park, and we'll be seeing that segment after the break.
That's great. And I have to say that I started glancing through the book and just reading a little bit of some of the essays, and they were funny. They were funny.
Yeah, they really are. They're hysterical. He's a funny guy.
Oh, good. All right, well, stay tuned for Elaine's interview with Michael. And as always, if you want to learn more about what's happening at the library, you can
click on our website,
give us a call,
or better yet, come on in and see us in person.
Stay tuned for Miss Elaine's interview, and we will be back with you next month.
Thanks. See you then.
So long.
Yeah, I kind of pick some of the funniest ones. That's up to you guys to judge.
Okay.
So.
Okay, so now that we're on the book, go ahead and tell us inspiration behind. How do you get your ideas for these articles?
It's funny. I was thinking about humor and how I started with humor. And I remember years and years ago going to my Aunt Eleanor's funeral. And I remember people were at the funeral. I know, I'm talking about comedy, and I went straight to funeral. But I remember being at the funeral, and everybody was standing around laughing and telling stories, and I got a little angry. I was like, everybody's so cheerful. And it was like, no, they were remembering Eleanor, and they were remembering what she was like, and they were telling their favorite funny stories about her. And that's what we do as people. When something bad happens, we get together, and we try to see the funny in it.
We try to make each other laugh and remember the good times.
Right. So, you know, I try to, that's what I'm trying to do. There's a lot of things in the book. They're like little things that annoy me, little things that aggravate me. But I'm trying to see the funnier side of it.
Good.
Yeah.
Very good. You're looking at the glass.
Looking,
half full,
yeah.
Half empty,
yes,
right?
Exactly.
Very good. So I ask all the writers that we have, authors on the show, can you pinpoint a time when you're like, when did you know that, hey, this is what I'm good at, this is what I want to do with my life. When did you know you were a writer?
Oh, that's a good question. No, I wish I knew that when you were asking that, because that's good. That's a good question. No, that's good. Thinking back, I think I remember for the first, like, having a comic book or seeing a TV show, of thinking one day, oh, look, there it says written by. Like, for a long time when you're growing up, just that stuff just comes. The Brady Bunch just shows up on your TV.
Yes.
And you don't know that people are actually back there writing about
yes.
it. And then one day, like, you go, oh, that was, like, a really good episode of this or that. And you go, oh, that's interesting. And you find, it says written by, and all of a sudden you find that out. And you're like, hey, I want to do that. I actually went into journalism. I had always wanted to write TV or movies. And I have written a couple films. They haven't been made yet, but they've been optioned, which means somebody in L.A. bought the right to make it. They just never made it.
Okay.
Because it's a very big endeavor trying to make a film happen, millions of dollars, that I didn't have.
Right.
My house, so you can tell I don't have millions of dollars.
It's a very lovely house. Oh, thank you for inviting us in today, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
We're here in Scott Township on location. Okay, let's see. And I also ask this question to a lot of our authors then. What advice can you give young aspiring writers? What do you think is the most important thing that they need to remember if they want to pursue a career?
You know, that's good, because every time you hear that question, every author always says, write, keep writing, write what you know. Those are all true things. You should always keep writing, write what you know. I don't write every day. I try to. I'm a bad, bad author. So I try to write every day, and I stick with it as much as I can, you know. But write every day. Don't get discouraged. Be willing to change yourself. If you get advice, if somebody comes along and critiques
it, that's an important one.
Yes, make sure that you go, oh, okay, because
able to take that constructive criticism,
right,
and apply it.
A lot of stuff we see in our head, we don't really, sometimes it doesn't come out on paper the way we want it to.
Right.
And it still happens to me, actually. So I still get rewritten and have to rewrite, and
that's just all part of the process. Nobody writes a perfect piece.
It never came out perfect. You should buy the book and know it'll never come out perfect.
Speaking of the book again, can you tell us how it's available? There is one or a copy on order at the Bethel Park Library, so of course patrons will be able to get it at our library. But how else can they purchase the book?
You know, right now it's available on Amazon.com. Exclusively currently there. It's going to go wider soon, but right now it's available there. It is only $8.95, which is a good selling point,
right.
Cheaper than a movie.
Yeah.
And I'm hoping a little bit more, like, longer entertainment. You have a little more entertainment value.
Excellent. What else can we look forward to seeing of yours in the future? Are you currently writing anything else?
Well, I write the column every week for the weekly, so that's still happening weekly.
Okay.
and every Saturday in the paper. And I still, I still do stand-up around town, and I've been hosting a lot of charity events lately, which has been a lot of fun.
Excellent. I know you just did a cabaret for the cause.
Cystic fibrosis.
Tell us a little bit about that.
But you know what? Cystic fibrosis only gets, they get all their funding from donations. So they don't get any government money, so they have to bring it in, and we raised a bunch of money. We had a bunch of local singers. I introduced them, told some jokes.
Acted as the MC,
and tried to make people as happy as we could. And the singers were fantastic, so it was a really easy job.
Excellent.
And a couple other things coming up. I'm not sure what's next. There's always something.
Good. Keeping busy.
We
are hoping to get you at the library. I know, if not this winter, definitely for 2013.
Oh, so anytime, yeah. Glad to come.
So you can check them out again at the Bethel Park Library. But we wanted to thank you for being on the show. And again, everybody, it's Below Average Genius, available on Amazon.com for $8.95 or for free at the Bethel Park Public Library. Our copy should be in within a couple of
weeks. Free is better. Free. Go get what's free.
So I do have one more question for you, Michael. Tell us, Below Average Genius, how did you come up with this title? Very intriguing title.
Oh, okay. The reason I have the title Below Average Genius is because one day I was sitting watching television, and I was watching the Wheel of Fortune, and I got, like, every single one right. I just was like, boom, ba boom, ba boom. It was simple. And then, like, in that same half hour, Jeopardy came on.
Yes.
And I knew none of those. And I was like,
I thought
I was a genius for Wheel of Fortune, and then I thought I was an idiot for Jeopardy. So that half hour did a big number on my ego of television. And I think a lot of people feel that way. You're watching Jeopardy, and they're asking you, who are the Knights Templar? And I'm like, I don't even know who the Knights Templar are.
It's so funny you mentioned that, because I haven't seen Jeopardy in a while, but I always try to break my record. And I think the most questions I ever answered on Jeopardy was 9.
Oh, that's good.
It only happened once. So we've talked about how this is just a compilation of all your articles. Can you give viewers just a little sneak peek and maybe talk about what you think is the funniest, or what is your favorite one in here?
Oh, that's like trying to pick the favorite child. As a mom, I'm sure you know you can't pick your favorite kid.
No.
I have a couple of things in there that I really like. The first one is called Come to My House, which is about me going over a friend's house for a movie. And when you go over there, it's a lot different than going and sitting in a movie theater. You have to adjust to, like, somebody else has the remote, and you have to deal with the fact that they have the remote.
Oh.
You have to eat what they put out, and if they don't put out anything you like, you still have to go, oh, thanks.
Pretend like you like it.
That's lovely. Thank you.
You don't know if you
see
your shoes
on. Right. And then the phone rings, and then they're on the phone, and I'm stuck there watching Ryan Reynolds like this, because the movie's on pause, and I'm waiting for him to do it. He's in mid-leap, and he's going to do something. But
That's true.
It didn't happen, and I gotta wait for them to be done talking about their Aunt Edna's bursitis, or whoever they're talking to.
Very good, very good. So you prefer going to the movie theater?
I like to sit down in the movie theater. I get popcorn. I get what I want.
Very good.
Or even watching something at home. I can watch it in my pajamas at home. So.
That's true. In the comfort of your own house.
Exactly.
Very good. Well, so if you need a laugh, folks, I encourage you to check out Below Average Genius. Again, we'll be available at the Bethel Park Library, but also on Amazon.com for the very low price of $8.95.
I'm taking her with me.
How about that?
Can I take her with me and have her do that everywhere? That's
Thanks
awesome.
Thanks so much for inviting us out here today, Michael. Thanks.